Good day to all of you, ladies and gentlemen. This is Mr. Fae, and here we have the butt of a dead enemy. Here is a very nice butt of a dead enemy, too much hair, but it doesn't really matter because this is not the point. The point here is this guy, Magakos, the Oracle of Zeus build. And finally, we are very close to the end of Ragnarok Act. We are in the fifth act of the game. Of course, after the fifth act ends, we have to go to play Atlantis with this one, but Atlantis is the last act of this character's journey. So, after we reach Atlantis and finish it, we will be done with this character. Finally, after 2 years playing this playthrough of this character in legendary difficulty, one day, in the very near future, hopefully, we will be done. Done, Karadan. So, but before we are done with this character, of course, we have to continue playing. And now here in Ragnarok, we kill some enemies. We go there to the Yggdrasil route. We have to open up this route and pass through. I have to be careful because bleeding damage is going to kill me. Bleeding resistance minus 82%. It is not a good idea to come to Act 5 Legendary, the Ragnarok Act, while you have minus 82% bleeding resistance. Wait. This one is perfect, perfect, perfect. Nice. This one is very close to perfection. Very nice. This one is perfect for such a class. Okay. The only true problems that I have with resistances are with pierce resistance, which is minus 1%, and of course vitality, which is totally super bad, and of course bleeding resistance. Here we go. What is that? These enemies here reflect damage sometimes, so you have to be careful. So please, be careful. Let's see. A bone pile. Yes. Yes, Sprigglings. Sprigglings, yeah, they are dead, come on. We are going to fight a very big boss right now. I call this boss the Titanic because it has a very lengthy body. The length of the body of this boss is a very big one. This is why I call it the Titanic, you know, the ship that got sunk. I don't even remember the word, the past tense of sink, anyway. It was sunk. Something like that. Yeah, the Titanic boss. So, we will kill the Titanic boss now. Let me clear this area first. Okay, no good items. I have only one health potion. Yeah. First, I have to go back to town, one of the towns, and buy some potions. Let's do that. I have 31 energy potions and only one health potion. Let's go to Jotunheim. This is not a town. This is a waypoint, and next to the waypoint, we have only one merchant. So, yeah. All we need is potions right now. I don't need any management of my stats and things like that to be doing. So, let's go there.
What am I doing here?
I don't know.
What does it look like?
Who knows?
I bet you didn't know that we Virgir are respected for our craft in all 9 realms.
I don't care.
And found a way to travel anywhere at our leisure.
Who cares?
Well, except Asgard. Vodin put a stop to that.
I don't care. Are you done? Your stories about Asgard and your kind. I don't care about the stories. Sorry, but goodbye. And I'm not even sorry. What did you think? Did you think that I was going to say sorry, but goodbye? I have matters to attend to. No, not this time. Maybe next time. Okay, what do I have here? I have the scroll of the crashing vortex, and here I have the scroll of the crashing vortex. So much for diversity. If I was going to be using something in this battle, I would use this one, even though this one is physical damage. Physical damage is not the problem against this boss, but anyway, let's use this one because I want to get rid of this scroll. Yeah, the boss is dying very fast, and it is a good thing that I'm face tanking the boss, because right now, yeah, face tanking the boss means that the boss will not use raged attacks, and the raged attacks of this boss are the very powerful attacks that can kill you if you don't have good resistances. This, oh, what? Wow! Wow, just wow. The base armor is awesome of this item, and also 140% health regen. This is a keeper. I will keep it in my collection of items. Well, my new collection of items, because I have lost my full collection of items after I reformated my PC and I reinstalled Windows 10. I kept backups of the wrong file of Titan Quest Vault 2, and I lost my full collection of items that I have kept in my Titan Quest Vault. So, it was my mistake, it was not the mistake of Titan Quest Vault. Don't be afraid to use Titan Quest Vault. Titan Quest Vault is an awesome external tool. Congrats again to the creator of this tool. You can store infinite amounts of items, whatever items you may want to storage in within this vault. It is perfect. It is a perfect tool and it works pretty much fine. But you know, the mistake was mine. I forgot to back up the right folder. And I got a backup of a wrong folder, and I didn't save my collection of items. But of course, this has nothing to do with the character saves. I didn't lose my characters. I kept the right backups of characters, and I have all of my characters. And here we are, continuing playing with this build, which is the Oracle of Zeus build. And here we have a bone pile. Okay, these enemies are good for now. I mean, they do not really kill us, they don't have chances to kill us. So far, so good. Legendary, yeah. And of course, in my collection of items, I had many rare items, many powerful items, but I also had many hundreds upon hundreds of crafting materials. And by crafting materials, I mean components, charms, and relics, complete ones. I'm collecting all of the charms and relics that I complete throughout the game with my characters. I keep them all in my vault, because I use them in recipes for artifacts, or maybe I figure out a new build and maybe I will need one of these charms and relics that I keep in this collection. So I save all of these items, components, for future builds, and also for creating artifacts in the future, and who knows what else. But I lost all of them, and I had hundreds upon hundreds of crafting components. So it was a very sad moment when I realized that I lost my full collection of items. But is this truly a problem? Well, you know, I still have many characters, you know, the builds that I have made, I have played with, and new builds that I have made that I haven't played with. All of these characters of mine, I have about 65 to 70 characters. All of my characters are holding some items in their stasis. and also inventories. You know, the characters that I have played with and finished the game hold many good items in their stashes and inventories, so I have already started making a new collection of items. I have plenty of items still. But some of the very good items that I lost by losing the collection were super rare items like Giant Tooth, for example. And you know, Giant Tooth doesn't drop very frequently, it is super rare. Aeonius Shield, Giant Tooth, set items. I had some complete set items. I had. What else did I have? I had many artifacts. I had. Many items that I don't remember right now. You know, you understand what I mean, what I try to say. I try to say that my collection is gone for good. I lost it for good. But now, we started making a new collection. And okay, the truth is that I'm going to be playing this game for a long time still. I'm not stopping anytime soon. If possible, I will never stop playing Titan Quest. This is my plan, but I don't know if I can... for this plan to work, I probably will need to turn this thing with YouTube and streaming to a full-time job. If I can do it, then yes, I will never stop playing Titan Quest or any other games. But I don't even know when and if this will ever happen. So let's keep going. This is one of my favorite places in Ragnarok Act because it looks very... it reminds me a little bit of Hell at Diablo. You know, it is a very dangerous place, dark place, place of death and destruction and oblivion maybe, and chaos. I don't know about chaos, but it looks awesome. I like very much this lava thing here. It has some very nice types of enemies, the giants, and also I like these flying ships as well. What else? Yeah, nice atmospheric music. It is awesome! Wait, have I... Yes, I've been everywhere. Let's go! Now our goal will be to go and kill the fiery demon boss in this episode. Bam, bam, bam. Somehow I feel like these enemies have no chance to kill me, which is awesome. I don't know what will happen against the final boss. You know, Saturn, because that boss sometimes also reflects damage back to you. And it also hits very hard with physical attacks, melee attacks. And if it hits me, I'm dead, I guess. I will receive lots of melee damage, physical damage and whatnot. And I will have to be careful. But the great thing is that my fire resistance is perfect. It is 80%. So that boss deals all the time fire damage. And I don't think I will have any problems with the fire attacks of the boss. But when it comes to the rest of the attacks, physical melee attacks and whatnot, yeah. And damage reflection, yeah, we will have some problems there. Okay, damage reflection against this boss is easy to avoid because you know, you can see when this boss has his damage reflection on. Which means when the boss is at his second phase, a big, very big demon giant, something like that, not the first phase, which is a small humanoid giant. When it is at the second phase, sometimes it casts the heat shield visually effect on himself, which is something like the heat shield that we get from Earth Mastery. It is something like this. We can see on this on Lich King, he has something like an aura around him, like a spherical aura. It is similar on Surtur, but this aura on Surtur is red or orange, the color, something like that, I think. Something like orange or red, light orange. Anyway, yeah, when you see the boss having this aura around him, this means that at this time damage reflection is active. So, you should probably avoid hitting the boss with your attacks when he has damage reflection on. And you can see it, you can see when damage reflection is on, so you can avoid it actually, you have to be careful. It is, we could say, a similar thing to Typhon boss, because Typhon boss also deals damage retaliation and also reflection at the same time, but he does these things only he has his thorns out. And when the boss gets his thorns out, you can see that his body has some thorns now. And you know that at that time, at that point, you don't want to attack the boss, because you will receive back damage retaliation or reflection, or both at the same time. It depends. Damage retaliation works only with melee attacks. Damage reflection works with everything, except for damage reflection. I mean, you cannot reflect damage reflection. If you have damage reflection on you and the enemy has damage reflection on him and you hit with an attack your enemy, you get back the damage that you deal on your enemy, but he doesn't get back again the damage that you get from his damage reflection. Opa! Let's go this way, there is nothing here. Yes, no, and yes, and no. Okay, there is nothing here. Let's go to the fiery demon boss now. We have some giants to fight in this place. These guys here are giants. They don't give me any good items though. We will go this way. Ah, there is nothing here. Okay, let's kill these big salamanders, lizards. Salamander, salamander, salamander. Very easy. These giants are very easy to kill. We have more giants here. Let's kill these two giants and go left, because this is the way to go to the fiery demon boss. Okay, I received lots of damage here because we had many giants at the same time hitting me with their swords that deal lots of pierce damage. My pierce resistance is super bad. Super bad. Super duper bad. But I still survive. Why? Because I use the squall skill with the obscured visibility add-on of this skill, which reduces significantly the damage that enemies deal to you. And it helps with survivability greatly. Ba-da-bum. Nice. Let's go this way. We shall kill them all. Every last one of them. Giant demon, I'm not afraid of your fiery attacks, but these they throw projectiles and I think they also deal some pierce damage, maybe not. But their fire damage is insignificant now, so we will have no problems in this place. Very nice looking dungeon, by the way. bone pile. Param pa pam pam param pa pam pam. That was a mistake. The outsider is here. Outsider, destroy the boss. I'm not hitting the boss. My pets are killing the boss now. I'm only casting squall on the boss. Come on, boss, die please, outsider, come on. Okay, let me hit the boss because it will take some time to kill it. Yeah, very easy battle. Okay, something tells me that in this area I will have zero problems, even against Sertor. But I don't know about Loki. Loki's close by, but we will leave the battle against Loki for the next episode. Let's kill these enemies here. Yeah. Come on, don't run away, please. Let me scold you. My Lich King is dead. But anyway, it doesn't really matter. We have one more enemy to kill. Oh, yeah. Ah! How did I miss this enemy? Right, okay, let's go ahead and clear this place before the stairs. I will kill some salamanders now. The beasts. The beasts. Ta-ra-tan-ta-ra-ta-ra-tan. There is nothing, that was a trapped chest. But you know, these trapped chests in Act 5, they usually deal lightning damage. And my lightning resistance is perfect, so even if it hits me, I will not die. It will be insignificant, I guess, the damage that I will receive. Let's go, actually, let's go and kill Loki. Loki is very close by, so let's kill Loki. Very nice, very nice. Zero deaths so far in this episode. Demon is down. Oracle of Zeus is winning the day today. Let's go here. Giants. Gigantic sons of mothers of grandfathers. Three more birdie enemies to kill. Chaos Imp. These Chaos Imps remind me of imps that you meet in Morrowind. Not Morrowind, sorry. Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. In the dungeons of Daggerfall. Ah, the memories, Daggerfall. A super crazy, huge game. With hundreds upon hundreds of dungeons, cities, towns. You know, I only wish one day somebody would transfer maybe that game on a 3D engine. As it is, you know, just use today's 3D graphics, for example, add some quality of life improvements, and let us go and play in that game. And let it have all of these hundreds and thousands of dungeons and whatnot, cities, towns. That would be awesome, but it is a super huge game, and this will never happen. So, all of my skills are active. Let's go. Let's see. Can I not get killed by Loki? Especially in the first phase of actually, I can.
Stop here. Titans.
I cannot stop here. I used one more scroll. Whoa! Whoa! I am shoot to no. 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 I underestimated Loki, boss. Why? I Puerto Rico. That was a huge mistake. Come on. Come on. Yeah, Loki is using a spear and too much burst damage. Maybe I should wait for Outsider to refresh. This is Crashing Vortex. Okay, let's go. Okay, come on. Come on now. That was a very unlucky moment, as you can see. It is not a hard boss for me, for this build. I was just super unlucky. Come on. That was not fair. That was an unfair death.
You have to play the hero, don't you?
Oh.
Ow. But you're still too late.
Yeah.
I prepared the gate in Asgard, and Surtur's opening his side as we speak.
I don't care about Surtur, I'm going to kick his butt. This battle was not fair. This death was not fair. Come on, I don't play. That was very nasty. Very lucky. This Loki boss was very lucky this time. He got to kill me? The Oracle of Zeus? What? How dare you killing me, the Oracle of Zeus? With your stupid spear. And it was not a good spear. Okay, so everybody, we will stop here this journey. Well, in the beginning I thought that we would go in this episode, through this episode without dying, but Loki had to kill us because he was very lucky. Loki was lucky. Yeah, the lucky Loki. Not Lucky Luke, Lucky Loki. So, we will come back to this playthrough super very soon, as soon as possible. And in the next episode, I guess we will go and kill Surtur. And after that, we start Atlantis, finally. Atlantis with this Oracle of Zeus. Oracle of Zeus will visit Atlantis. Yeah. Anyway, I will see you very soon. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't done yet. If you like what you said, you want to see more, subscribe and more will come. And I will see you super very soon. Have fun whatever you do and don't die against Loki. The lucky Loki.